All right. At the top of the hour, we're going to take a break, and we'll be back in a moment with more news and views. You know, one of the things I wanted to cover was Catherine. You had the that case that we talked about back in November, and you had some jury nullification going on there.
Yes.
I wanted to mention that one.
I did have a good case, and you know, I tried, not to be offended by the last caller saying we're just not winning this way, because you know, I have to say, in 2017, I did win almost all of my trials. You know, Nydia's conviction on misdemeanor obstruction was obviously a big disappointment, but it was coming off the heels of a really great victory down in Lawrence County for a man named Antonio Willis, who he was charged with 2 counts of distribution of marijuana, which in Georgia can get you a maximum of 20 years in the state penitentiary. You know, we're talking about, you know, small amounts measured in grams. And the jury found him not guilty, despite there being video evidence of a marijuana transaction taking place. And I suspect it was because the jury did not like the shady way that the officer went about conducting this drug sting on someone who was just, you know, hardworking guy, happened to be between jobs. Somebody comes up and approaches him, says, "Hey man, can you find me some weed?" He does the guy a favor and then finds himself getting arrested.
Jury nullification.
We'll get back into this one
jury
in a second.
Jury nullification.
We've got a caller. Do we have 2 callers? Judge, are you out there? All right, we've got a first caller. We've got Tom McCain on, and he is the executive director of NORML, of all things, while we're talking about.
And he came to watch the Antonio Willis trial. It was so fantastic to have him there and get his write-up that was able to get the attention of the Atlanta Journal-Constitution.
Tom?
Well done.
Hey!
Hey, Tom!
Left him on hold too long.
How you get too big?
It's hard to figure out which one of you two is over 70.
Hey, we are talking about some very distinguished men
who
have lots of great law enforcement experience. You know, Tom especially, as he's executive director of Peachtree NORML, and the fact that he spent his career in the military and law enforcement, I found really people listen to him. They listen to his perspective on the drug war.
That's actually, you know, very interesting that you're running an organization like NORML and yet you have that background of military and law enforcement.
That was a very military answer. He gave you what you needed.